Thanks everyone for joining us for MonsterVision. This is going to be a semi-weekly look at the Fresno Monsters, everyone's favorite Western States Hockey League team in first place. Season's winding down. We're going to chat with a few players today, and we'll have a fan perspective coming up a little bit later on. My name's John English. I'm the play-by-play voice of the Fresno Monsters, and I'm here with Ty Wright, Petr Philippov, and Max Karlenzig. Guys, thank you for joining us for this this first episode of MonsterVision.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, thank you.
So, guys, we're coming off kind of a tough weekend series with Ontario. Dropped a couple games at Selland Arena. First off, what is it about those guys? Because I know there were a couple tough games earlier in the season as well. And how do you set that aside? What are you guys doing? What's your preparation this week looking like as far as kind of trying to put that in your back pocket and move on?
Yeah, it was tough. They're a tough team to play. They like to play hard. They like to play physical. Early on in the season, they didn't really have the numbers. Like a lot of the teams in the league had struggles with numbers. And we walked all over them the first game we played them. And then I think after that, we keep coming into those kind of games thinking that it's going to be an easy night. And when we know in the back of our heads that they're going to come out firing, they're going to come out hot. So in that case, we end up having some tough games against them, and we haven't had the success that we've been hoping for lately. But I think moving forward, especially with Ontario, we just got to keep looking towards playoffs, making that playoff run, having a good showing. We got to be working hard. I know last weekend we were not on our game, and it showed. So I think moving forward, especially in every game that for the rest of the season, that we just need to be at our best, and we have to demand the best from all of our players, and that's it'll just fall into place after that.
What do you do after a series like that in terms of, it can be you guys individually, it can be what Coach Trevor's putting you guys through in practice and things like that. What do you guys do differently after something like that? Do you just set it aside completely, or do you, is there video work? Is there, what do you guys do in particular to move past something like that?
Me personally, I want to take a look at my game individually first. I want to see what I did wrong on the goals that I let through, kind of evaluate that and see what I could have done better there. And then I reach out to one of my goalie coaches and a mentor to me, Joe Clark, and I have him kind of watch over it, and then he'll give me some tips and the good and the bad, the ugly is what he calls it. And then go into practice, trying to work on those same things that I saw I did wrong, and just try to keep my body healthy too, of course. Take a day to rest after the series, and yeah.
Petr, what about you?
Usually I'm try to, like, after a game, like, forget about this game because we have games in front. And but yeah, like, I still remember, like, bad moments from the game where I've been, like, wrong. So I try to fix it, like, at practice and getting better. So, like, it's, like, simple. Yeah. That's it, I think.
Okay. So, obviously, as we're taping this, Las Vegas tomorrow night at Gateway, and then San Diego's coming in this weekend. They've won 7 in a row. Actually haven't lost a regular season game since, I think, 1st of December or somewhere around there, first week of December. They are climbing. Where are your guys' heads? What is the mood this week as you get ready for a team like that that is starting to make a run?
I would say just we need to focus less on what they can do and focus more on our game and just make sure that we're playing to our best ability, make sure we're running our systems well, and just stay focused. And we cannot underestimate any team. Even if we beat San Diego before, I mean, they beat us as well. We just have to stay focused on our game for sure.
Yeah, I think San Diego is another one of those teams that they're a tough team to play against. You get frustrated against them, so you got to keep it simple. Notice what they do right on the ice, but expose what they do wrong on the ice. I think that's what we need to do against every team, though. But with San Diego coming in, we have to take them like those games we had in Vegas in the showcase when we played Northern Colorado and Utah. We didn't get the result we were looking for, but I feel personally that was the hardest hockey we've played this season. So I want to get back to playing that style of hockey. That's a tough hockey to defend for sure.
Yeah, I agree with Ty and Max, and I think we should play like our game. We don't have to look like how San Diego playing, how like Ontario playing. We should like just play our best game and like do all what we can in every game, because it's like getting close to playoff and there's gonna be like really tough games for us.
So, playoffs, Thorn Cup, are we making a run?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
No question.
That's always the plan.
Yeah. How much do you guys get a chance to look at some of the other teams playing on the other side of the country, as far as you know, some of the other outside of the showcase, getting to see some of those teams at all before the playoffs?
Really, for me, it's just I see them on maybe like Instagram or Facebook, the highlights. Sure. You see what they can do on the ice. Sometimes they'll put up team plays or individual plays. Mm-hmm. So you get to see kind of what they're looking like, but obviously that's not really an in-depth look at them. So, I mean, as I said before, like, you got to come to every game prepared the same way. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter who you're playing. You should be playing your best game every time.
Great. And so what's next for you guys personally after this season? Because I know, you know, there's the opportunity to move up. what are you guys looking to do in the last couple months that we have here for this season in terms of raising your own stock and getting opportunities, if not in the WSHL, higher up for next season and beyond?
Well, I mean, first things first, I want to win a cup this year. Mm-hmm. It's my last year of junior hockey, and same with Ty. And I know we both have the same intention to go all the way and get a piece of silverware under our belts for junior hockey. And then after that, I've got a few college opportunities that I might take. I still have to do some thinking about that, and kind of I'll see if I'm going to get any more offers, kind of wait on that. And then I have a potential opportunity to play professional next year in France. So,
great.
Yeah, I want to go the college route, same as Max. I've got a pretty good number of colleges that I've already talked to, and hopefully I get some more in, same as Max. Hopefully we're getting some more in at mm-hmm. towards the end of the season here. I've also got a few professional offers overseas in Germany and England and Sweden, so I got some decision making to do for sure. But of course, I think all of our minds right now are just set on that Thorn Cup.
Right.
Yeah, I agree like with Ty and Max about right now we should think like about Thorn Cup, because it's like I think like we're better than like any team and we can play our best hockey there and like we can win that. But like about me, I have like one more junior season, so I don't know. I really just No, I'll go home after the season. I'll take rest like 2 weeks and getting ready for my last season of junior hockey.
Get right back into it.
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to wrap things up here shortly. I want to kind of do like a lightning round sort of thing. Just going to fire off some questions. Any of you guys that want to answer them, jump right in. Have as much fun with it as you want. You know, I'm not responsible for any trouble you guys get yourselves into with these. All but right. You're spending a lot of time together as a team. Mm-hmm. A lot of that's traveling, I know. A lot of it's here. Specifically the road games and things like that, who's the best guy on the team to travel with?
Oh, boy.
Who's the guy that's always got snacks on the bus and always got, you know, he's all the guy that you just, if you got a room with somebody or something, the guy you want to be with?
Well, first and foremost, who's snack guy?
Snack, probably JL. JL's a pretty big snack guy. He always comes on with a load of snacks with him.
Yeah.
sometimes he doesn't like to share, which kind of stings a little bit. No, I mean, all the boys are real good to travel with. I mean, of course, you spend a lot of time with each other over the season, and so you get on each other's nerves a little bit, but that's just a part of being family. But all in all, I wouldn't have it any other way traveling with these guys.
We all have to share beds, so I would say the best people to travel with are the ones that aren't flopping around too much in their sleep, or
preferably smaller in stature.
Maybe not too smelly.
Yeah. Yep.
With that in mind, worst guy to travel with.
Zach Turpin. Hands down.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Terps is a good guy. Yeah. I can't say enough good things about him, but the man has a certain musk to him.
Okay. Opposing player that you wish was a monster. Who's the one guy that you guys have taken on this year that, in Max's case, you see him coming towards you and you're like, oh no.
I don't know if I've ever said oh no about a specific player. It's more of an oh no about like a group effort coming at me, mm-hmm. with like one guy, mm-hmm. in front of me.
Who's that one guy that sticks out on the opposition that you guys would like to have here?
Well, I know we wanted, what was it, Kane? What's his first name?
Corey Kane. He was in West Sound, mm-hmm. and now he's playing in Seattle. We were really trying to get him here. And now we're Nikita Guerin. Mm-hmm. He plays for Valencia. He used to play for the Monsters, and we're trying to work out a deal with him. He would be a great guy to have back on the roster. Other than that, there's not really at this level. There's so many good players, mm-hmm. and the talent level is so close together that you don't really notice like too many of like the superstars, you know, like you used to see in minor hockey who would put up 15 goals a game. Mm-hmm. So the competition's just so even now that, I mean, obviously, even there are still the superstars out there, even in the NHL level with like Connor McDavid and mm-hmm. all of those guys. But if I were to say anybody that I've come up against, it would have probably been Ben Doherty that plays for the Utah Outliers. He's their captain, and the guy's just an animal on the ice. He's one of those guys where he's unpredictable. As a defenseman to mm-hmm. defend, he's unpredictable. So you don't know what he's going to do every time he comes down the ice, and he's got very quick feet. He's smart with the puck. So that's the type of guy I would like to have on the team. Because that really throws a team's game off, is when you have guys that are unpredictable, that you don't know what they're going to do every time they have the puck.
One last thing. Favorite thing about playing in Fresno?
The fans.
Fans?
Yeah. It's always rowdy, and it really sets up a great environment to play in and somewhere that's really fun. I mean, I've been around to a few teams this year, and the fans in Fresno are always just – it adds so much to the just playing for the team. I mean, there's just so much going on out there, and everyone's so ecstatic to be in Selen. So,
is it tougher playing in the bigger building than at Gateway?
No, I wouldn't. I would say it's the same. If anything, like they give me more of a energy boost, and I got a lot more adrenaline in me, so I'm playing faster and harder. Mm-hmm.
What about you, Peter? You haven't said something in a while.
Yeah, of course it's fans, because I think we have like Mark said before, we had like best fans in the league, I think. And of course it's like a good organization, and everything is what you need to be better here. So
Fresno has been my second home for, this is my third year now, mm-hmm. and I just love it here. I love the weather. Coming from Canada, I don't like the minus 40, minus 50 we get back home in the winter. So that was a good change. And the fan base, like the other boys just said, is incredible here. Everything's treated so professionally compared to a lot of other organizations around. And I like that a lot. It really kind of gets you settled in a lot quicker, a lot nicer. You get into a better routine. You get knowing your surroundings better, what you can and can't do, what you have and don't have. So, and especially with selling to Arena, that's a big stage for a lot of these young kids. And I think that's going to be a big attraction for any more young players coming into the WSHL. They're going to want to look at Fresno to come and play at the big rink. So,
well, we certainly hope so. And guys, it's been a pleasure. It's always fun to watch you guys, and good to sit down with you and kind of talk about the team and things a little more than we might ordinarily get the chance to do. So we appreciate you guys taking the time. If you're watching this, Thursday night, Gateway Ice Center, 7:15, the Las Vegas Thunderbirds will be back in town. And then Friday and Saturday night, 7:30, Selland Arena, join us out there as well. Monsters always put on a great show, and I think we're about ready to kick off a 3-game winning streak this weekend here coming up. So thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Back from break, I'm John English, the play-by-play voice for the Fresno Monsters, here with Kala Mullaney and Brian Rivera. Kind of talk a little bit about all things Fresno Monsters here on MonsterVision, and wanted to chat with you guys both about, you know, things that are going on right now, but let's get a little bit of background, too. I know we're going to kind of be coming to you guys for some fan perspective and things like that, but Kala, you've been part of the billet program now for a while. How does that work if somebody wanted to get involved? Give us a little rundown on everything that goes into that.
Well, the first person you would want to contact is Sandy Hyatt. She is the billet person of, she holds all the responsibilities for it, so she's the one that gets you in that you would get in contact with. She does all the logistical work to get the players to where to the houses, to make sure that the players have vehicles to get to and from practice, because the family themselves are not responsible for the players to get to and from practices or games. That's the player's responsibility. All we are responsible for is basically to feed them and house them, and then anything else after that is just bonus, really.
Right, because for those who don't know, I mean, these Monsters players are coming from all over the world.
Exactly.
They need some place to be while they're here playing hockey, so it's a fantastic thing that people like you are doing to, you know, help these guys chase their dream down in the sport of hockey. So
yeah, absolutely. We have two kids. This is our second year, by the way. We wanted to do it a long time ago. We just didn't have the room. We do now. We have two kids, or two young men, I should say. They're both from Sweden. Last year we had one from Switzerland and one from Canada, and it's the experience is way beyond what we ever thought it was going to be. It's great fun having these guys coming in. Plus, we all love hockey in the house, so that absolutely helps. So, you know, we have all something to talk about and chirp about constantly to them when they have a bad night, or even a good night, we'll still chirp them all the way home. So sometimes it's pretty fun.
That's great. And Brian, you were an assistant coach for a while for the Monsters, and been involved in Fresno hockey for a long, long time.
Yeah, very, very much so.
Tell us a little bit about your background and where you're at now.
Okay, born and raised here in Fresno. I played in the minor program here. I coached with the Monsters for 6 years. Right now, currently, I'm coaching the 8 and under youth program to basically get them their basic skills started so they can start playing in the minor program and hopefully progress to one day being a Fresno Monster.
It's fantastic. Fantastic. We're coming off a pretty tough weekend for the Monsters. They had Ontario come into town, dropped 2 games against them. They did beat Valencia last Thursday night. Got a really tough matchup coming up with San Diego coming into town for the Selland Arena weekend series here on Friday and Saturday. They'll play Las Vegas one more time before that, tomorrow night as we're taping this, Thursday night at Gateway Ice Center. What did you guys see last weekend that you think we need to pay a closer attention to? I mean, three of us have been watching hockey forever, and I'm watching from the press box. But what did you guys see from ground level watching the team this weekend? I felt like they were kind of on their heels that whole series against Ontario.
I agree. I don't think they were prepared for what Ontario was going to bring along. I mean, Ontario's got to make up a few spots, make up some points to get to the playoff position they want to be in. So they're pushing hard. It's the end of the year. They know where they're at and where they want to be. And, it's that time of year now where you're going to have to be focused and ready to go, because as each series comes down, you're going to be closer and closer to the playoffs. And for us, if we want to hold that, number one spot, we got to expect everyone's A game every time they come here, because that's what they're shooting for. They're shooting for the number one spot. So I think we, as a group, they need to be ready to play. I don't think they were ready at all.
I think we definitely were outplayed. We were outplayed, outbodied for sure. They came out and immediately started playing the body a lot more than what Fresno is used to out the gate. Fresno usually is when they want to play the body, they come out and they start making a physical presence, and they just came out and did it to Fresno, and they were on their heels most of the game. I don't think that Fresno played a horrible game. I think they just didn't play their game, and they were kept that way for the six periods of play for the whole weekend.
It seemed like to me shutting down their passing game would have helped tremendously, because every time Ontario had possession of the puck in the Fresno zone, it was like they were centering it and putting it on net over and over again.
Yeah, I agree.
And, sooner or later, those shots are going to get by even the best goaltender. And I think Max is probably a little bit tired in terms of he's been playing a lot lately. And, the other guys stepping up is going to be key down the stretch, too.
Well, 100%. You definitely... Claude and I here are both Avalanche fans, and we were just in the other room talking about the goaltending situation there. And it happens every year in the playoffs, no matter at what level. You have to – both goalies have to be ready to play at any given time and any given night, because one guy is not going to get you the whole way there. You look at Pittsburgh a few years ago, Fleury was in net. He got hurt. Murray came in, he held the reins for a little while, then he got hurt, then Fleury came back in and ran for a little bit, and then he stumbled, and then Murray went back in, and before you know it, they're lifting the Stanley Cup. And, at that point in the playoffs, it's, like I said, eight game, be ready to play, because you never know when you're going to be called.
It was good to see things a little bit tighter on Saturday night with the big crowd in the house for the military Law Enforcement Appreciation Night. They had the larger crowd there. It was a really rough showing Friday night, so I was glad to see them tighten things up a little bit on Saturday. Sure to be some more big crowds coming as the season winds down at Selland Arena. Hopefully they will be able to show up for those games and get things that much closer to a playoff run. I was looking today. Fresno has not had a hockey championship since 2002. Is this the year?
That's a tough one.
This is a tough league, and once you get into the Thorn Cup with that round robin and everything, it's impossible to call it. But
exactly, you think you would have your same stalwarts there, El Paso, Ogden. They're always used to be right in the mix all the time, and I know El Paso is notorious for making crazy moves to strengthen their team. Just a few weeks ago, they plucked a couple guys from Las Vegas. Mm-hmm. Ogden did the same thing. If the Monsters can play their A game and be ready to go, they're going to be just as good as anybody in the league. It's just whether or not they can bring it on a consistent basis.
It also depends on how that puck bounces around, too. If you get the good bounces, you can go in any direction.
I think that, I didn't get to see the start of both the games, but, down walking the concourse and you're hearing goals by the other team in the first minute or two into the game, that's, yeah. that's a big kick in the shin right off the start. That that's you know, the at some point they're going to have to nail those down and be able to play for an extended period with no score.
Who's your guys' favorite monster to watch?
Well, I'm kind of biased on that one. It's probably going to be – I got two, and well, I should – I have to put three because I have two of them. It's probably Will Markstead and Sebastian Nielsen. Nielsen is the goalie that was there on Saturday night. I like watching him play. Nothing against Max by any means. I just like watching because I know him, and he's a very quiet, quiet guy. He does not talk for anything. When he does, it's even quiet. And that transitions into his play. I was just telling you yesterday, I says, you know, I watch you, and you're just so smooth going across the crease. It's like there's no panic whatsoever. So I like watching that, and I like watching Will, because if he scores, we give him cakes. If he gets assists, we give him cupcakes. And the other one is going to be Jackson Baumel, because he was our billet last year and another great kid. And watching him go from without the cage or from with the cage to without this year, and him trying to get more physical because he did turn 18 over the offseason, and now watching him and seeing what he does physical-wise and stuff like that, that's probably my – top three, and they're hard to
put over above. Me personally, I like watching Leach, Baker, and it seems whoever they get paired with. Whenever they get on the ice, it's just like a bunch of bees swarming all over the place, trying to run into everything and you know, throw a hit here and there, or you know, just be agitating. That's just at this level, it's fun to watch because not every player can take that sort of they're not used to it. You know they're coming from a midget or a bantam hockey where it's, you know, you don't have that. You just play the game. Well, here, you know, you're going around and you're trying to agitate guys and do your thing to get them off their game. And I think when those two get going, it's fun to watch.
Now, I don't know the guys, as many of the guys personally, like obviously like you do, Kala. The guy that I have really seen pick up his game as of late is Mikhail Gavrilenko. He is, every time he's on the ice, it seems like he's the fastest guy on the ice. And like, Brian, like you were saying, he's just in the middle of everything. I think he's been playing on that line a little bit with those guys. And you know, guys like that, that have that speed and that quickness and that quick reaction time, like he's showing, I've just noticed growth just from the start of this season in him. So he's a lot of fun to watch for me.
He's one of those players that you can put on any line and it's going to elevate that line one way or the other. You know, and you're right. He's right there in the mix. You put him in with Baker and Leach, and he's running around the ice. You put him with Turpin and Philippov, and they're running a power play. So it's, yeah, he is another good player to watch.
What are you guys looking forward to this weekend? As far as the
I would just like to, like I said at the start, it's just them to clean up their game a little bit. Starting right now, you know, there's just a handful of games left, 6-7 games left, somewhere in that range. And you know, at this point, like I said before, you got to start cleaning up your game, being more precise on the breakout. You know, not turning the puck over at the blue line, making sure we're hitting the net on the power play, making sure we're getting pucks to the net. You know, we're getting those little plays that always decide a game. You know, there's always that one point you'll make a turnover and it'll lead to breakaway and a goal. You know, those little things like that they have to start eliminating those and play a lot cleaner.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think also what we need is more fans out there, to be honest.
Yeah.
And the reason why I say that is because I think the Monsters play to the bigger crowds. You get the gateway crowds and, you know, it's freezing cold in that place, but people still come out, and the Monsters understand that. But when you go to Sellin and you get the Friday night crowd, and you know, you don't get like how we had on Saturday, but when they came out to Saturday, you saw a more elevated play. We got more physical. They played to that crowd. So I think if we got that crowd in there, shameless plug to get people in to watch the games, I think the Monsters would play to that, and they would understand that, hey, you know, we're playing to this crowd. We need to pump them up a little bit more and get them involved. And
it's all part of the process. That's right. Those people are still here. They will come back out. The Monsters just have to make that statement that they're a team that people need to see.
100%.
I think with this last couple series of the season and playoff run, they will do just that. Guys, I appreciate you taking the time.
Sure.
Thank you so much for joining us here on Monster Vision. Get out to the arena. Gateway Ice Center tomorrow night, Thursday night, 7:15 p.m. Fresno Monsters taking on the Las Vegas Thunderbirds, and 7:30 p.m. Friday and Saturday night at Celland Arena against the San Diego Sabres. Thanks so much to CMAC for letting us film here, and we will see you next time here on Monster Vision.